Divya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We can start it off.
Failure is not the opposite of success. It's a part of success. Respected principal, sir. Respected dean, ma'am. Respected registrar, sir. Respected HODs. Respected faculties. And my dear friends. A very good morning to one and all. I'm Divya Raj, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, SVCE. I feel privileged to welcome you all to the workshop on entrepreneurship and innovation as career opportunity organized by the Department of CSE and CSEAI in association with Institute Innovation Council, IIC Cell, SVCE. Prayer works wonders. Prayers should spring from the heart, thinking of a supreme power beyond all human inadequacies. I request Professor Tejaswini to render the invocation song. Ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Sharanu Vinayaka Varashubhadayaka Modala Poojayu Ninage Binaka Sharanu Vinayaka Gauri Sutane Gajamukhadayyane Gauri Sutane Gajamukhadayyane Gajacharmambara Shiva Sutane Sharanu Vinayaka Varashubhadayaka Mudala Poojayu Ninage Binaka Sharanu Vinayaka. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. It gives me an immense pleasure to welcome you all to the session. I first welcome our Honorable Chairman, Shri V. Muniyappa, sir, and our respected CED, Dr. Shashidhar Muniyappa, sir, to the session. They are unable to join us today because of their busy schedule, but conveyed their best wishes for successful completion of the event. Thank you, sir. I now welcome our beloved principal, Dr. Nageshwar Gupta, sir, to the session. Sir, welcome you to the session, sir.
Yes, madam. Good morning. Thank you.
I now welcome our today's resource person, Dr. Poonima K., Associate Professor, Department of MBA, SJBIT, and also Business Consultant and Soft Skill Trainer, Freelance, Bengaluru, to the session. Ma'am, welcome you to the session.
Welcome. Thank you, ma'am.
I heartily welcome our respected Dean, ma'am, respected Registrar, sir, respected HODs of all the departments of SVCE, respected faculty members, and also dearest participants to the event. Welcome you all to the session. I now request our IIC convener, Dr. Nirmala S. Gupta, ma'am, to address the gathering. Ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, Divya, ma'am, and good morning to Principal Sir, HOD Sir, and all my dear peer members and my dear students. So today we are gathered to do one more event under Institute Innovation Council, IIC. Which normally aims at, the IIC aims at fostering and building, constructing a culture among all of us, the faculty, the staff, and the students, to have an innovation entrepreneurship ecosystem to be there in our institute. And it is the main motto of Ministry of Education, MIC's culture, so which has to be bought in to the institution. So it has been started in 2018, and the main aim of this MOE's MIC was to launch this IIC, Institute Innovation Council, in all the higher education institutions. So which is a program, to be frank, a cell which is going to have the culture to be bought in and an ecosystem to be built for all the process from the scratch, that is idea what we are all having an idea. So we need to come out with that idea and we need to start working towards the solution to get for that idea. So that was the intention. So it is having a big cycle of activities under this particular process. So which completely gives from the idea, then we try to design our project as a problem statement. Then we try to work towards the solution. Then we try to bring out a concept, that is proof of concept, we call it as. Then that proof of concept can be converted a patent, because our own work it is, so we can patent it. So there the IP plays a major role. Then after the IP, how do we bring out an industry, or how do we convert this or transfer this technology to the society? So there the product development and product is to be incubated, pre-incubated, then incubated. Then finally, we bring out an outcome to the society and for all of us for the usage. So like this, it's a complete ecosystem, I could say. So all of you are equally the part of this ecosystem in SVCE. We, the IIC cell, not only conducting the activities for showcasing the talents of all the students and the faculties and the staff members, and bringing an awareness and the knowledge to be given to the whole student community. So again, in turn, we wanted to convert this knowledge into an entrepreneur. So you can become a good entrepreneur with the support of the management, CED sir, principal sir, dean ma'am, and all HODs and the peer faculty members. So you can make use of this particular IIC as a platform. So thank you, Divya ma'am, for giving me an opportunity to brief out for 2 minutes about the IIC, Cell SVCE. So thank you once again.
Thank you, ma'am. I now request Dr. S.C. Lingareddy, sir, head of CSE department, to address the gathering. Sir, over to you.
Okay. Good morning. May I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good morning. It's a great privilege and honor to be a part of this program, event, workshop. So we chosen, I mean, the workshop, they chosen entrepreneurship and innovation. So entrepreneurship and innovation are the two sides of business coin. Entrepreneurship and innovation are two close words which are used in present market in business practice, research scholar, and in policy making. It is very difficult to understand that there are different from each other. Entrepreneurship and innovation have multiple meaning. So entrepreneurs are individuals which bring innovation. To be a manager and leader, need to have different ideas to change. Entrepreneurship and innovation, which creates changes and opportunity in business. So most of our students, they are thinking to start their own startup, and I hope this program will be helpful for them to grow, and this program will helpful for them to get some knowledge out of this. So I would like to thank our management, Dr. Shashidhar Muniyappa sir, Chief Executive Director, and Dr. Nageshwar Gupta sir, our beloved principal, and IIC convener Nirmala Gupta ma'am, and all the organizers, thank you very much for conducting this type of activity which boosts our students. And also I would like to thank today's resource person, Dr. Purnima K. So ma'am may give insight on innovation and entrepreneurship to our students. Thank you very much, ma'am. Over to you.
Thank you so much. I now request Professor Ranjit V to introduce our today's chief guest to the audience. So over to you. Sir, please unmute your mic, sir. Ranjit, sir.
Ranjit sir, you are not audible, sir.
Yes, sir, you are not audible, sir.
I think the volume control might be. Check it out, sir.
Unmuted, sir. Ranjit, sir.
Ranjit, sir, you are not audible.
Ranjit, sir, unmute ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡಿ. Ranjit, sir.
He is in unmute, sir. I mean, he is not in mute.
No. I think some problem might be with this connection.
Yes, sir. Connection, sir.
We need to do. Okay. Madam, I think if you are having that particular detail, Divya, madam, you can start the process, madam.
So, Divya, ma'am.
No, I don't have.
I will.
Okay, madam, you can do it.
Okay, sir. Just 1 minute, sir.
Yes, madam. This is.
Yeah, it is opening ma'am's profile actually.
Okay.
Okay. Good morning to one and all once again. It's my privilege to briefly read out the profile of today's session speaker, Dr. Purnima K. So, Dr. Purnima K, madam, is a very career-oriented lady. So, ma'am is currently working in the Department of MBA as Associate Professor at SJBIT. So, ma'am has got 17 years and 5 months of total experience collectively, both teaching and industry. So, ma'am was also worked in various other institutions earlier as Associate Professor in Global Academy Technology. Worked as MBA department in the capacity of senior assistant professor in Rewa University, and worked as a faculty, MBA faculty, in the lecture capacity in East Point College of Higher Education, Bangalore. And even ma'am was worked with even BBM Institute, that is Sri Siddhaganga College for Women at Tumkur. So, ma'am has got additional credibility or the role working as a guest faculty or a visiting faculty in Sri Devarajaras College of Nursing, Kolar, Palagatti, Adavappa Arts and Commerce College, Tiptur, and still she as one of the ex-employee who worked in Siddhaganga College for Women, ma'am still goes as a visiting faculty for BCom Scholars. So, ma'am has got the qualification BSc, MBA, HR and Marketing, PGD, FM, then PhD into her profile. So, ma'am has done a lot of certification courses from Coursera, Google, NPTEL, MOOC on, to be frank, to say very few is innovation, business model, entrepreneurship, digital marketing, the social and technical context of health, and a lot more from the reputed agencies. Then ma'am has got a lot of credibility in giving the lectures like this, how she is with us today. So she has given a lot of guest talks, seminars, workshops, trainings in various institutions and organizations on entrepreneurship as a career choice, entrepreneurship and innovation as a career opportunity, then mock interview conduction for the students, communication and marketing for the staff. And even she has been the part of the guest lecture or a guest speaker in more FDPs on HR analytics, personality development classes, entrepreneurship awareness camp, and a lot more. So professionally, ma'am has got a lot of achievements in terms of the board of studies. She is being the member for autonomous MBA program in Global Academy of Technology. She's been the board of syllabus member, means board of studies and syllabus framing member for the management subjects in Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Technology. And even she has presented over 20 plus research papers in various national and international conferences and journals. And even she has got the book publication into her credit, and three research publications are being given with the highest score of citations. And even ma'am has got a lot of other credits into her account and recognition in terms of research work. Also has the best paper awards. Ma'am has won almost, I could say, three papers as the best paper award in the international conferences and the others. And even she has got a best study venture award from IISc Bangalore in 2016. And entrepreneurship related, though, she got a lot of activities wherein she was herself as a speaker, as an organizer, and even she was actively participated as a program coordinator. So still more to say. Sorry, not to take much time of ma'am to give the session to all of us. So I am just closing a brief profile reading of Dr. Purnima K. ma'am for today's event. Over to you, Divya ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. I request our today's resource person, Dr. Purnima K. ma'am, to address the gathering.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Nirmala ma'am. You would have just briefly told I'm one among you. That's it. I'm also into teaching fraternity. Thank you, Divya ma'am, for a nice beginning. And first of all, am I going to share or how it will be? I'll be only sharing.
No, ma'am. Just address the gathering.
Ma'am, you have been made as a presenter. You are a presenter. You can share it from your end only, ma'am.
Madam, you can share. Madam, you can share. You can have the synchronization between your presentation and your speech. No issues.
A screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, madam, this is visible.
Okay. Once again, thank you all for believing in me and being in a teaching fraternity. I feel that I'm one among you. We'll be having a reciprocation. First of all, I humbly thank the principal sir and the management and the entire team of IIC and Nirmala ma'am specifically, because she believed in me and trusted me in my skills and abilities. And first of all, when ma'am asked me to give a talk, I was like, okay, because she's my friend, yes. Then when I looked at the kind of credentials, what your organization, your institution have, I'm really amazed. So I feel even I do have a lot of things to learn from your end also. So principal sir and the entire team, I really thank you for having so many credentials for your account. I could see on the banner, in the mail, whatever I saw. Really the amazing one. I have seen many other institutions where for namesake, they'll be having some cell, but hyperactive cell is one that I could see here. So the entire team, a big round of applause from my end for all of you. Okay. Yes. To start with, for all the students here, I'm making sure that I'm not going to teach you anything that is too much difficult or complex. Being from management fraternity, I'll try to make it very simple and very relevant to the society and how well you can gear up to take up the challenges of the society. For namesake, you should not just enroll for any courses, right? So here all my presentation don't have any word text, purely PowerPoint. So maybe by the end of the session, if you have some value addition takeaways, that makes my day. And by looking at the kind of activity, now itself, I'm assuring my friend Nirmala Gupta ma'am and as well as the principal sir and the entire team So whatever may be the activities, if you feel that I can involve myself, I'm very much happy by looking at the kind of credentials what you people have, right? Really amazing, really amazing. So I'll begin my session by stating. Yes.
So let's have a presidential remarks by principal, sir. And immediately after that, we'll start your session, ma'am.
Okay, sure.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. And good morning to all. First, as Madam clearly said, the achievements of this IAEC cell, let me briefly give. This IAEC was started 4 years back. The first year, our IAEC cell have got the Southwest, that is SWRO they call, Southwest Regional Office. Under that particular rating, our IAEC cell stood first. And it was given as a certificate of appreciation from the MIC. There is a the particular cell which has been under MHRD earlier. Now it has been associated with the Ministry of Education. Subsequently, we have got the star rating. Okay, in that particular thing, also we have got 4.35 star rating the subsequent year. And the last year, that is the immediate previous year, we have got rating 4 because the maximum rating that they have declared as 4 instead of 5 because various events were conducted online. That also we stood first amongst all other institutions. So that is the credentials that we have got with that. And subsequently, our management is feeling that, see, most of the students, when they enter into professional courses, they generally look for job. And parents also ask whether my son or my daughter will be getting a job. But our management want to change that particular process. So here, the process of knowledge sharing will be based on this particular process. Initially, the first accomplishment that they need to go for, and they need to transform themselves to be an entrepreneur, that is the employer. So they will be giving job to the many people. If they fail to do that, then they need to go for higher education. So that means they have not specifically, in general, they learn something like computer science engineering. Now under computer science engineering, they want to do something related to health informatics so they can go for higher studies. So that will be the second accomplishment. If they fail in that particular process also, then they can go for job. So this is how they categorize. So based on this particular categorization, we have modified certain process within our organization that is also integrated with our curriculum and which we are practicing. So with this particular small input for the resource person and all other students, I conclude. Thank you and all the best for this particular event.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thanks to you, sir. Spite most of welcome, traveling yes. And reaching and really joining to the event, we are all, the entire team is thanking you,
yes,
sir.
Yes. Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
You learn something new every day if you pay attention, and today is a great day to learn something new. I wish a happy learning and a great day to all. Thank you, and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah. Thank you. Once again, I thank Principal Sir for briefing out. Yes, IAEC's activities are really hyperactive, I could say. With that background, I'll setting stage for my presentation. So I'll move ahead with my presentation. Okay, ma'am? Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Is this in full screen mode, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Very good morning to one and all present here. Dear students, you know well, just now the entire team of organizers of your institution have taken time to make use of this online platform for you people by organizing workshop. All right. So hope this 1 hour session will be fruitful, and I would like to hear from you well. To begin with, just let me start with a quote. If you say, I may forget. If you write, I may remember. But if you involve, definitely will do. That is what your teachers are doing here. As organizers, apart from teaching the curriculum and preparing you for university exams, typically what your teachers are doing is they are adding value to your course, not just with a degree. So if you have only degree, what will happen? It is like having color TV or home theater. But your value addition, what your teachers are doing is by giving cable connection or internet service. Hope you are able to make out what I said. Is it right what I said? My teaching fraternity will definitely agree, because they are not restricting you people only for teaching and making you to write test or internals and write exams and getting the scorecard. Beyond that, they are adding value to your course by organizing such events. So today we'll be having one such session wherein I'm going to talk about entrepreneurship, innovation and opportunity. Okay, so I'll move ahead with my presentation. Yes. Can any one of you guess who are these three people? Leave about the person on the right side. Name itself is indicating. Can you tell me who are these two people? From the left, first and second. Any guesses? Any guesses? I think they can't speak, isn't it, ma'am?
They can put it in the chat box.
Okay, okay.
Dear students, please put it in the chat box. Chat is enabled for entire organization.
Okay, sure. Okay, what we'll do is you keep on thinking about these people, then we'll come back to the session. Then I'll try to highlight why I have shown those three persons picture. Okay, the first thing is, when your IIC is active and organizing such event, before sitting for this event, this session, you think like an entrepreneur. So lot of ideas and maybe bubbling in your mind. So how to take on that? I'll tell you. Can you tell me who are these three people? Any guesses? I have given some small
clues.
Please
raise your hand. If you are able to answer, please raise your hand.
Or else you can put it, as ma'am told, you can post it in chat box also.
Chat box also.
Yes. Okay, at least have you seen the lady in the top? Okay, so we'll go ahead with, I'll start with this story of how these people and started their venture. What is that innovative idea they thought? The first lady on the top, you could see in the background, you could see IOCON, means you can easily make out she is Kiran Majumdar Shah of Biocon, isn't it? See, when people are with different background, different ideas, by starting her activity, a social activity.
Sorry to interrupt, Purnima ma'am. I have enabled the mics to everyone.
Okay,
I think
okay.
You can question them. And okay. That you can unmute and you can talk. Unmute. Because I have set the option, so you can all unmute and have an interactive session. There is no
Yes. Okay. Yes, thank you, ma'am. Guys, can you tell me, any one of you, how Kiran Majumdar Shah started her business? Okay, so let me tell you, being from biotech background, after doing her MSc from Bangalore University, being a rank holder, she was so much into nutshell, somewhere she decided she wanted to start a business. So before that, she went to abroad to learn about brewing business. Once she came back, people started laughing at her. Being a lady, because that time during 1980s and late beginning of 1990s, it was a social taboo wherein ladies talking about starting a brewery business. But slowly she understood that this brewery techniques and being from a microbiology background, she felt, why can't I venture into the biotechnology business? That is how she started her venture. The small, small innovative ideas, you know well, the kind of small, small innovation that made her to get into business or to start venture. Over a period of time, Biocon is the first Indian multinational that is listed in stock exchange, means that has issued initial public offer, right? The second person, the right side, Shanmugam Armuganandan. Have you seen Padman movie? Have you seen, at least have you heard about the Akshay Kumar enacted in that movie, Shanmugam? Okay, so this person, again, it's a social taboo talking about periods, all this. The society was like that. But being by looking at her, the problems, what her wife was facing during periods, he himself tried and tested how painful, how hesitation ladies were facing. Then he came with a product. See, the problem has made him to think about the solution. With small changes, that ideas that he twisted as small innovation, even though it may be incremental, small volume, but it became a big business. And down, all of you heard about Bounce, isn't it? Have you heard about Bounce? Have you ever used? Yes. Yes, someone is interacting, happy to make a note of it. Okay. You know well, in city, commuting is a big problem with heavy traffic, and people, if they don't have a two-wheeler, maybe when they go for very far off distances, in between they may try to commute between using maybe public vehicles. That will be too much of crowd, or auto fellow or a cab fellow may charge too much. And they understood that even cab going in Ola or Uber, sometimes if it is not too much requirement, then this guy, Vivekanand, engineering graduate with his friend, they felt that why can't we make a services by providing commuting vehicle that can solve the problems of many people who wanted to commute for a limited distance with lesser cost. Right? So that is how they got an idea that innovation doesn't mean that it should be always bigger one. Right? So this guy, Vivekanand, the Bounce and the Bounce story, how they made up big in the market, everything you are aware, right? So the way they are attracting investors, the kind of ideas what they bought into. So they understood people are facing problem of commuting. And the other side, people don't want to spend too much. So with a reasonable traveling cost, how one can provide service, this is what this guy has done. So here also a small innovation is implemented. What is that? People are facing problem, and these guys try to mend that by giving a solution. All right? Yes. Now we have come to the actual stage. How many of you ate or know about Gone Mad chocolates? Have you tasted?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what is so different between other chocolates and this Gone Mad? What's the so special, specific difference that you could make out between the others and this one? Okay, I'll go ahead. See, in most of the chocolates, you're trying to say? For example, in other chocolates, typically wafers will be inside and it is coated by chocolates, cocoas, right? But here, Gone Mad, just look at, the wafers are rolled, inside the choco fillings will be there, cocoa fillings will be there. right? So this is the difference between the ordinary chocolates with wafers and this one with the wafers, right? So that's why this people, Gone Mad company, it's a collaboration of Indonesia and Indian based company. This company felt that how to make a market footprint by making a small change. That idea is what they got, is twisting, giving a twist to the existing product, right? What twist they made? Rather than having wafers inside, they made wafers outside and filled the chocolate inside. And they named the product as brand as Gone Mad, right? Okay. Can you look at the second picture? What can you make out by looking at the second picture wherein a guy sitting with a lot of shoes that is kept on rack? What is that depicting? Any idea?
Okay. Here students interact. There is no problem at all.
However, yes, feel free.
Unmute and feel free and talk to have an interactive session.
I want you to get lot of ideas by this. Okay, can you make out? Okay, I'll go ahead.
Unique way of shoes.
Sorry?
Unique way of keeping the shoes, shoe rack.
Yes. Different rack. Yes. Okay. Yes. So typically what will happen in our day-to-day life, you might have come across Dobi will come, the washerman, the laundry services for clothes, isn't it? So those who can't afford a washing machine, or those who feel that they wanted to have professional touch or very clean and hygiene clothes to be washed and pressed it to before wearing. So they may rely on laundry services, right? And sometimes what happens in our daily life, you might have spent too much money on purchasing shoes, very premium brand, Puma or Reebok, Adidas or Nike brand of very high brand shoes, very costly shoes. But what will happen after, maybe when you practice, when you go for field after practicing, or maybe the way you walk, sometimes there may be wear and tear, some dirt may happen, right? But you may be having some emotional attachment with the shoes or the studs, so you don't want to throw, or part of the shoe may be torn, or you don't want to throw just for first instance, you want it to be cleaned and repaired, right? So by looking at this kind of situation, and a guy by name Sandeep Gajakas, okay, you can Google it, you can know more about this guy who is sitting in this picture that I shared here, Sandeep Gajakas. He got an idea by completing his engineering with fire engineer specialization background. He was working in a call center because first time when he shared with his parents that he wanted to start a business, being a person from father being in a defense background, father did not want him to set up a shoe related business, but he was okay with starting any business. But this guy felt that there is an opportunity, there is a lot of scope for to start something new that is not there in the market. So what this guy did here to raise the money, as family did not support, he worked in a call center. Through his earnings, whatever he got by working in call center, he invested on setting a company wherein the company takes out the shoes that need to be cleaned and washed. It's like typically laundering and repairing and maintaining. Okay. And this, he in 2003 in Mumbai suburb, he started a company by name The Shoe Laundry. Have you heard about shoe laundry? No, right? Typically what will happen, people feel that laundry means it's only for clothes. He got an idea. That idea he converted as something innovative. How? If you look at roadside cobblers, whenever you want to mend your shoes or slippers, so what will happen? We will be going and standing, or you may wrap it in a plastic cover and you are giving to him. And roadside, that on footpath, he may be mending your soles or the shoes or sandals, whatever it may be. He may charge 20, 30, depending on, right? And there's no expectation of giving very professional touch, because everything he'll be doing in that cobblers will be doing in hand, all right? And the hygiene, all this we may not expect, and it's very difficult for us to get that kind of posh kind of a feeling as a customer, right? Sometimes you need to stand till they mend the shoes or slippers. And this person came with a brand and he started the company by name The Shoe Laundry. So when way back in 2003, people started laughing at him, right? So when everyone is doing a very posh and premium kind of business, a guy with engineering background, why he went to start something relating to shoe, wherein cleaning the shoe, mending soles and stitching, giving new design. He's not going to produce anything, but he's going to give a new shape, a new revamp for the shoes, old shoes that were given by the customers. And you may not believe, by the time when they were doing in 2003, for every set of premium shoes that they are going to mend it, they used to charge 99 rupees, like Bata's odd pricing. So 99 rupees. Over a period of time, there was a lot of demand for him. At present, they are charging 180 rupees per pair of shoes. By the end of 2019 and 20, per pair of shoes, cleaning and giving, like as if it looks like a neat earlier how it was when they purchased, and they're charging around 180 to 200 rupees, and an average per day they are doing service for 3,000 pairs of shoe. Think about the volume of business they are doing. And as there's a lot of demand for shoe laundry services, he even expanded the franchisee model by calling people, those who can have a gel with his business, his mindset. And right now he is doing this franchising in the name of Shoe Vival. So Shoe Vival, what is the meaning of Vival? Viva, Vival means long live, the French word. So see, what I wanted to say is the idea, what he got is how to give a new look for a product and expanding that services, that by converting that idea into innovation, that innovation has become a business model. Hope I'm making sense. Am I making sense? Do you think it's relevant? Yes. So when we were discussing about this guy, Sandeep Gajak, usually what will happen, only you might have heard about Swiggy or Flipkart, Amazon. People will take your order through online. They'll be coming and delivering your product or service, right? Even the same ideology, the same business model through franchising, this guy, Sandeep Gajak, is running this shoe laundry service by taking order and delivering order to your doorstep. And for all these mending shoes and cleaning shoes, repairing everything at a cost of 200. Just think about when you are spending your on your shoes for 2,000 rupees or 3,000 rupees shoes or studs. Just for small tearing off or mud, that dirt, whatever happens in your shoe, you don't want to throw it, right? By just giving 200 rupees, if your shoes' shelf life is going to increase by another 2 years, definitely you feel happy, isn't it? All right. Okay. So now I'm going to take you through who can be innovator. Just now we have taken two small instances. We speak about Armugam. We spoke about Vivekananda of Bounds. We spoke about Gone Mad Company. And we spoke about the Sandeep Gajak of the laundry service. What is the first thing I have highlighted in red? Innovators do different things. What is not there or what is there? And they'll make an assessment of that, scanning the environment. So what is there already? If you do in different way, you can do a business. Then we'll call it as innovation, even though it may be incremental or small volume. Okay, so innovators do different things. So when everyone is doing a similar Kirana kind of business, when everyone is doing selling shoes by taking a franchise of Bata company or Liberty, whatever it may be, this guy has gone out of the box. So they thought differently, right? So innovators do different things. When everyone thinking about laundry means only for clothes, this guy felt that laundry is also made for shoes, right? Second one is they do different things differently. Okay, they do different things differently. You looked about Ola and Uber. So what do they do? The company has attached cars, those who are owning cars, with their company, and people like us, common people who wanted to commute or travel from one place to other place, we were connecting to the cab driver or the cab operator through Ola or Uber. But if you look at the case of Bounce, they do different things differently. What is that? When everyone was thinking of hiring a cab for rent, for traveling, this guy Vivek Anand, he felt that, yes, even two-wheeler can also be hired. But they added a twist. What is that twist, that innovative idea they bought? For booking Bounce, you can use app, digital platform, and there is no need of having a driver because it's a two-wheeler. Wherever you wanted to go, you can book it and you can take it. So in the similar way, you heard about Zoom car, right? So that is how, when Uber and Ola already existed one decade back, 10 years before, the newcomer, the next person who is coming, should think about what is there and how better in different way we can do it. So they do different things differently. And because of this, at the end, they wanted to make a difference. They will make a difference also, right? So we speak too much about Ola, Uber, Swiggy. Foodpanda was there much early. But what Swiggy did? The way they are connecting with the hotel or restaurant and the way they are serving the customer, totally different. So that's why even though Foodpanda started much early, now if you could see Swiggy and Zomato, the rivals, right? So the late entrants, but they are making things different, right? Okay. Now, you may be thinking how one can become innovator. So for that, first thing is you should have fire in a belly and you should have a mindset. Then nothing is outside the universe. Nothing is outside the earth. Okay. You just think about where you are, scan that environment, look around, and you can get a lot of opportunities. So opportunities are in front of us. Only thing is we should have a mindset and perception, especially the way we perceive things about the outside world, that will give us opportunity, and you have to encash on those opportunity, right? Okay. To start with, if you can see, first thing, entrepreneurial background and investment. To be in, say, frank, entrepreneur background is not at all required for anyone to start a business, and money is not a criteria. If you could look at some of the business that the people have started, have you heard about Bindu Jeera?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What are they into? What are the various products from Bindu Jeera?
It's like a drinks where we can replenish, as we know. It's just a drink. I heard about it. A drink. Very
yeah.
A simple drink, what I can say.
Yes, yes. Okay. See, the guy who started this Bindu brand, Satish Shankar, was just an ITI guy. He completed plus two job oriented course, like where in nearby Puttur, he was just working as an ordinary mechanic and electrician in a small electrician company where they used to mend mixer grinders and television repair. His father was an agriculturist. Entrepreneurial background is not at all required if you have a open mindset to identify the opportunity. And investment, don't think that money is the only criteria to start business. No. If you have very good idea, I will take you to the people, those who can invest in your business. Come with a good idea, definitely I'll handhold you, and your IIC cell is there, your institution is there. We will take you to angel investors or the venture capitalists who can invest. If I tell, you may not believe, just with 5,000 rupees, this Satish Shankar has started business of mineral water package. So you know well, Bindu in Kannada literally means drop. Got clear what I'm telling? Am I making sense? Is it boring?
No, ma'am. No. Continue.
You're able to get?
Yes, yes.
Yes. So money is not a criteria. Investment. Just the 5,000 that too he has taken loan by in the name of his father from State Bank of Mysore in Puttur. Puttur is a small town in Dakshina Kannada district that I think most of you, if you are from Karnataka, you may be aware, right? By just investing 5,000, by the time in 1996, it was huge volume, right? The way he started his business from packaged drinking water, he ventured into fizz jeera. And here also, I would like to tell you one opportunity and innovation. Typically, what happens in South India, if any guest comes to home, we will give sherbet or lime juice, right? Remoulade to welcome as a welcome drink. But typically, if you go to North India, once when he went there to North India in some of the Delhi hotels, Jaljeera will be given as a welcome drink in any thali. Yes or no? I want you to interact. You are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so that Jaljeera typically the same flavor what we have in Bindu Jeera. So he encashed on that idea. He has given little bit twist and made it as a Bindu Jeera. Now in South India, from 1996, what business he started, by 2006, this company like Coca-Cola came and requested Satish Shankar, can you sell your brand? We are ready to purchase for 60 crore. I'm repeating once again, guys, just keep these numbers in your mind. 1996, they started business, and within 6 months, they expanded their business to entire South India, including Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. Within four states, they were able to make such a huge business for Bindu Mineral Water that Coca-Cola, they felt that this Bindu water is going to be a threat for them. And they gave an offer to him to sell his brand for 60 crore. Way back in 2006, 60 crore means if I would have been in his place or if you would have been in his place, we would have settled for 60 crores, isn't it? Happily. Right? But what this guy did, he told, no, I wanted to expand my business. Then he went to Delhi. Then he got this idea of Jeera. When Jaljeera was given as a welcome drink in one of the hotel in Delhi, he came back and he expanded that business. And right now, you may not believe, you may get surprised to know about this Satish Shankar's group, Bindu Jeera, Bindu brand. It is under Mega Food Investment Private Limited. At present, the revenue itself is 150 crore. Can you believe? Hope you understood why investment and background is not the major one.
Yes,
ma'am. Am I making sense? Is it boring?
No, ma'am. It's interesting. You can continue. Yeah.
You are able to make out?
Yes, definitely.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So that is what I'm telling. Criterias when you look at. The other thing is educational qualification and experience. No, don't think that this educational qualification and experience, yes, it will add some weightage. At the same time, try to identify the opportunity. Just now I was talking about Sandeep Gajak, right? So he did something related to fire engineer. At the same time, because most of you are from CS and AI background, I'm telling you by looking at the recent budget, how many of you read? You people do have a lot of scopes to start this technology, AI and CS technology background. You can encash on. Government recently announced in its budget that for drone technology, and that too, if you are using for agri-related, your educational qualification and experience will lead you to have subsidies and easily you can raise through Make in India and Made in India projects. And if you come out with innovative ideas and start venture, for 5 years, you are not going to pay even single pie as tax to the government. That's the kind of support what you are going to get. Identify that opportunity. Drone. Everyone speak about drone, right? So aerial products that you are going to venture. If you are using your technology, your course knowledge, whatever education qualification you do have, your experience, work on those projects and convert those projects as product relating to agriculture or any particular sector. And that can lead you to a business. So this is where you need to identify the opportunity, right? As I told, government has announced for 5 years tax holidays if you start business relating to drone or AI used technologies, the products and the services, especially if it is relating to agripreneur, agritech, then you will be getting more benefits. Identify that. Okay, so this is what I can say by looking at recent budget. Then location. See, when you look at location, it's a place or physical place and even the market where you want to do your business, right? So when everyone was thinking about commuting vehicle, and in Bangalore, commuting is a big problem, and some places where you are not able to make out traveling so easy, so look at something wherein the location itself is going to create having a lot of challenges that will show you opportunity. Okay, so relating to this, I would like to take you to this particular picture. Look at these three guys at the down. Have you ever seen these guys? Have you heard about Lalit Mangal, Sumit Jain and Vikas Malpani? Have you heard about?
No, ma'am.
Okay. No. Yes. See, these three guys are like you people. When they completed their engineering through campus placement, they got some offers. But when they were working, all these three guys are outside Bangalore. They are from North India. When they here, one of the guys studied in JSS Bangalore. All these three guys, when they got campus placement, they moved from college hostel to obviously after completing their course, they were searching for a room or house. You know, well, the typical problem in Bangalore or anywhere else also, usually for bachelors, most of the house owners, they may be very reluctant to give a house for rent because a lot of restriction. They feel that these guys may not, I mean, typical mindset of owners, the tenants, they may not keep the house premises clean. They may be a lot of issues that may relating to time. They may come untimely. It may create problem. All this, most of the house owners are very reluctant to give house for these bachelors. These three bachelors, what problems they faced by looking at the location, that means Bangalore. They looked at this issue. These problems, they converted as a solution, but by adding innovation to that. So these are the three guys who felt, okay, people like me who are searching for house for rent or lease, building, commercial building for rent or lease or occupants. So most of the time, if they go through middleman, they may charge something extra to bring house owners or the real estate owners with the people, those who are searching for the occupancy, they bought them on common platform. So way back in the beginning of 21st century only, they got this idea. What problems they faced, they converted this as a innovative idea and bought as a solution. You heard about Common Floor? Common Floor is a platform that is started by all these three guys. Hope you understood. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, moving on to the next, availability of raw materials. Look at what is easily available in and around. See, you people, as you people, your institution is towards Bangalore International Airport. You might have seen, you might have heard, and you might have read in newspapers and various social medias also. Nowadays, most of the IT guys are coming towards agri land. They understood that there's a land wherein they can do a farming, but by giving some sophisticated touch to that. They started coming and leasing the land, agriculture land, for 5 years, 10 years, and they are doing farming. It may be growing pomegranate or some commercial crops, fruits, and being very near to Chikbalapur, you people are aware that international airport is an added advantage for you, location and even availability of raw material. See, when everyone is started exporting only roses, why can't you people think about looking at some ornamental flowers apart from rose, like Jabira, Gladiola, Bird of Paradise? All these do have a lot of demand in the market, right? Being very near to Bangalore airport. So why can't you think about encashing opportunity by looking at the raw material? So relating to that, I have one particular example. How many of you traveled to Mysore, and how many of you recognized between Mysore-Bangalore highway near Channapatana, you might have seen Namma Organic or Organic Mandya? Have you seen this ever? Have you heard about Organic Mandya? No, if you are not, no issues. You can directly tell me. Have you heard about Organic Mandya?
No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So yes, the person in this
heard about it, and we are using it also, their products.
Yes. Okay. He's maybe I'll connect this person to you, ma'am. One day you can invite him to give talk. Very good person. He'll share his experience, because he's also from engineering background. Okay.
Okay. So nice. Yes. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. And he's from CS engineering background. He worked there in US. He started his own company by name Verifier Technologies. Almost for a decade, he ran his company in US. Then somewhere he felt that availability of raw material, basically his parents are from Mandya, that made him to come back by looking at the challenges what the farmers are facing. He felt like how Amul has bought all the farmers in the name of dairy cooperative societies. In a similar way, he designed. The innovation is not too much, incremental, bringing all the farmers on the same platform by making it as a Mandya Farmers Cooperative Society. Whatever product they were doing, rather than using chemical, he made them to use technology. What technology he do have, he bought a digital platform to make these farmers to sell their product in the name of Organic Mandya. And all these are using his business knowledge, his technology, and the raw materials is what these people, farmers, are growing. You might have heard about sweat blood, usually for blood donation, right? So here, this person has started a campaign, sweat. So what is that sweat? Sweat timing is, if anyone wanted to come to know about how exactly the farming will be done, because most of the people, they may not be having farmland, or they may not be from a farm background. He wanted people to come and understand the challenges and the problems that are faced by the farmers. And by looking at this, he wanted to have a visibility for the farmers. And for this reason, he bought a platform where, in the name of Organic Mandya, he is linking the customers like we people, who are very keen on our health consciousness and going for green concept, and the people, those who are producing, to get a very good reasonable price for their farm producers, right? Okay. Then the next one is market potential. So when you look at market potential, so look at what is not there and what you can do best. And till now, you are aware that in most of the farming land, farmers are facing a lot of problem. Like they may not be having a sophisticated technology to connect with the market, mandis. And you heard about ITC company? All of you might have heard about ITC company, right? So ITC, as a part of the CSR activity, they are doing e-chaupal. So what they're doing, they're connecting farmers to market by providing minimum support price and the prevailing mandi prices they're telling. So likewise, being an individual, you look at the market potential. In Bangalore, you know well, whatever you do, Bangalore being a very rapidly changing cosmo culture compared to rest of the metro and megapolitan cities in India, Bangalore is a major hub for any changes that you wanted to bring in, you can do it. Relating to this, I just would like to tell you about a small statistics. You know well, this Bangalore IIMs and almost all the IIMs in India, every year from 2000 onwards, 25% of the students are walking out of recruitment activities. They are not enrolling because they wanted to start their own venture. Once again, let me recall, beginning of this session, principal sir addressed, he told very clearly, we don't want our students only to prepare for recruitment and get into job. We want our students to start their own venture rather than becoming job seekers. We want them to become employers, right? So look at this market potential. The IIM statistics says that there's a reason why 25% of the students are not going for recruitment, because they wanted to start their own venture. For this, what you have to do? Look at the market potential. What is that market potential? If you, before starting any business, blindly don't get into by looking at others, first you need to assess your environment. What is not there in your area? How well you can exploit that opportunity? So market potential. Okay. Now I'll take you to again this picture. On the top left, one guy who is holding a mic. Can you see? Can you recognize this guy? Okay. Have you heard about Red Bus?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What are they into? What was Red Bus doing?
Ma'am, they were into like transportation during festival times. Actually, you know, a lot of people had to board the bus and
yes, you know, very nice.
You know, since it was festival time, it was rushed so much. And
yes.
So that's how Red Bus.
Yes, yes, yes. Very nice. What you said is absolutely right. Okay. This guy is Panish Sama. After completing his engineering, when he was working for a software company, he felt that in spite of a lot of commuting facility in Bangalore, because basically the problem what he faced, he felt that during festival season, there'll be a lot of demand for commuting vehicle, whether it is train or flights or maybe buses or private vehicle. At the nth moment, when some people will be there who are going to exploit too much by looking at the demand, right? From the customers, they're exploiting. So the personal problem what this guy faced during, because basically this guy is from Hyderabad. During Deepavali festival, he was supposed to board, go back to his hometown for celebration. His own problems, what he faced, he came back and he understood that there's a lot of potential in travel business. So market here refers to a particular industry. So he understood that IRCTC do have some limitations. Even there's a people used to face a lot of problem. Even in Tatkal also, there's no guarantee that you'll be getting service, right? And flights everywhere, you don't have connectivity through flights. Everywhere you don't have connectivity through train. So that is how what he felt by looking at market potentiality. So he bought people, those who are having travel services, and people, those who are looking for commuting services. He bought them on a digital platform. So the next one is by using technology, he bought them. And this is how he understood the market potential. So look at which industry do have. If market here doesn't refer to a particular location. Location is place. Here market potential is particular industry. And the same next one, next to that, technology. When you look at technology, see, lot of people do have, I mean, every now and then on your phone, on social media, you'll be coming across lot of apps. What is that? They are using technology. Dunzo you have, Big Basket started long back. Then by looking at the app, so making life easy, right? We do have digital payments. Can you tell me any two digital payment bankers that we do have in India? Any two?
Ma'am, GPay, phone pay.
Yes, yes, very nice, excellent, right? So GPay, phone pay, Airtel digital payment bank, we do have Paytm, right? They understood the technology. Till demonetization, none of us were very keen on using e-marketing or digital marketing services, isn't it? Now this technology has involved in penetrated in almost all the industry, may it be for clothes and accessories, may it be online purchasing of groceries, may it be purchasing of doing banking services, all industries. Look at where technology is not used. Now you know well, even if you go to small hotels, because you people are from CS and AI background, so that's why I'm telling you, nowadays, unlike earlier pen and paper taking order by the waiters in hotel, now the order will be on digital iPads or on tabs, isn't it? How they are using in different industry, that you need to use. What kind of technology is required, all right? And coming to the next, infrastructural requirement. Look at infrastructure. When we say infrastructure, everywhere, physical brick and mortar, that means building is not required to run your business. Even without that, you can do it. Can you tell me which particular hotel or restaurant, which particular brand is owning largest number of hotel and restaurant in the world? Sorry. Who is owning the biggest chain of hotels and restaurant in the world? Any idea?
Maybe Taj Hotel?
In the world, okay. Yeah, good, you made a good attempt. Have you heard about Airbnb?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So you just note down, later on you just go through why I'm telling all this. Okay. Airbnb, without having their own kitchen, without having their own hotel, they'll be having tie-up with majority of the hotels and restaurants across the world. So they are just working on a similar technology or business model like how this Swiggy, Foodpanda, Zomato is working. So don't think that infrastructure is the only requirement. When we say infrastructure, building does not exist also, they are doing business. So that is what Oyo is doing. Is Oyo is owning any, Ritesh Agarwal is owning any building, hotels, lodges? No, right? Without having that, how can you do it? You identify the opportunity. And the next is government policy. Yes, sometimes government policy. Just now I told about the recent budget. So all of you just make a note, go through what is a special government policy that is given for Startup India, and that too specifically about drone and agripreneur business. Okay, so this government policy gives some relaxation and some kind of freedom for you or motivation to start. Okay, and that to guys from engineering background with professional courses, you are having a lot of opportunities through the recent government policies. Tax holidays are there, subsidies are there, that you try to encash on it. And the next is availability of skilled manpower. So to start a venture, don't think that you require all experienced people. Look at people whose frequency matches with you. You start business, think about can a particular idea can be converted into innovative one, and can we convert that into business? Look at lot of organizations. See, being a students in your campus itself, why can't you first try developing one app that may help or replace some of the manual work, maybe in terms of assessing some activities relating to your institutions, or take assignment from your institution's HR department or admin department, how to streamline the fees, dues, messages, all this. So don't think that opportunity is, you require only experienced people to join hands with you. even with the like-minded friends of you, you can exploit the opportunity. And next, I told very clearly, pollution control laws. That's very, very important. So as pollution control laws are very strict, you know well, Ether company, long back, Chetan Maini came with Reva cars, right? But people did not understand. Now you see, everyone wanted to go for green energy products, maybe solar solar lights, solar panels to generate electricity, or everything that is going to be replaced from other mode of energy to solar energy to reduce the pollution. You can think of exploiting that opportunity, right? So now I'm moving ahead. The next thing, if at the down, if you could see, there's a lady with the Mahindra Bolero Jeep. Can you see? Is the screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Most of you might have not heard about this in social media. She's there. Even I provided a chance, if she come to Bangalore, I'll connect her to you people to address. Her name is Shilpa. Okay. She started a brand of Halli Mane Rotis in Mangalore. Basically from Hassan, you know well, Mangalore people more like to have a lot of idli, dosa, these kind of breakfast menus, right? And going there and her own life problems without having much education, she came with an idea, why can't I provide very hygiene, clean varieties of rotis directly from tawa to the plate of a customer. So she started that Halli Mane Rotis, and the Bolero pickup vehicle, what you are seeing, by looking at the kind of business what she is doing in Mangalore, Anand Mahindra, the MD and CEO of Mahindra Group, he gifted her this Mahindra Bolero pickup vehicle. And she was invited and she was given award by the better, most performing women by Anand Mahindra. See, these are small things that you need to. See, you know well, Mangalore people wanted to dip everything in sambar, right? Making those people to become accustomed to varieties of rotis. On the right side, you can see how she is cooking 15 different kind of varieties of rotis she is making with hygiene and hot and serving and doing business. So if you are really interested to get into franchise model to run, I'm not telling that you have to do rotis. She will send people. If you are really interested to start your business in this, I'll connect you to that. Now, Nirmala ma'am, how much time I'm left with?
There is no problem. If the children are ready, another 10-15 minutes is fine. Yes, guys, they are all ready, right? Another 10-15 minutes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah. See, how to identify the opportunity? So can you see a person here? Have you heard about Prahlad Kakkar? Okay. I'll put it very simple. How many of you are able to recall Vodafone Zuzu advertisement? Zuzu advertisement, have you seen? Are you able to recall?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah,
Britannia Little Heart jingle, tin, 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 tin. Have you heard?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Yes, the person behind this is this person, ad guru, famous ad guru, Prahlad Kakkar. So he is a person who was working for some company. Then he felt that Indian brands need to be showcased at the global level. He identified and he made advertisement to go in different way by adding jingle, by making the Zuzu characters are real human beings who are wearing that white color clothes, and it was portrayed as if it is like a cartoon character. So it became a big click, right? On the other side, if you could see MTR, MTR ready to eat foods. So what made MTR to get into this? They were in hotel business from many years, isn't it? Many decades, much before India got its independence. 1924 only they were into business. But over a period of time, they understood that in city or because of both wife and husband will be working, no time for them to cook. And there are few bachelors and spinsters who are staying away from their hometown. They wanted to have food that is typically like home cooked food. So then these people came with ready to eat. You might have seen even a single cube of rasam. If you dip in hot water, it will become rasam. Hope you are able to recall.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So all these ready to eat food, rava idli mix, lemon rice, whatever you say, they are into this. Right? This is how they created opportunities. So to start your fire in your belly. So you should start sowing the seed of your ideas to convert it as an opportunity. For this, what you have to do? First thing is you should have fire in the belly. How? You should be ready to take risk. And the next thing is plan, streamline, organize and manage. You may have some 20 n number of business ideas. Jot down, assess and scan the environment. Which industry, which location, where you wanted to go? Is there any scope? Try to do a basic research. Okay. Try to do a survey. If you want such any kind of survey related help, please come to me. Feel free. I'll be hand holding you, because right now I'm one of the student of my previous institution who is from EC background. He is doing online grocery app business in Mysore. I'm just helping them. That guy. Okay. So feel free. You can connect your teachers. You can come to me and we will help you so that you in real future, near future, I want you to see as at least some of you to start your own business. And you know, well, business is ever green. It is ever evolving. And at the same time, you should look at the global marketplace. Every seconds of the world, this universe is posing a lot of challenges. Right? So that's why we, as an individual, you think what is not there on this earth. And we never thought that sky is always, we used to say, sky is the only limit. Now you see, Elon Musk is already doing business there. Yes or no? Right? So entrepreneurs, they are the dreamers. When we say dreamers, pioneer, start. You should be the first one in the particular business or industry. Lead it, and innovativeness and invention. That is what will take you to have sustainable business. And by using disruptive technologies and products, right? So at present, to end this particular session, entrepreneurship of yesterday was just like the dhanda mindset. Dhanda means just doing, giving and selling. Selling concept. I have so-and-so product. I have so-and-so product. You purchase. I'm selling, you purchase. That was the mindset. Now, at present, startups of today is the panga mindset. Means challenge. Everywhere you are facing a challenge. So that's why the mindset or the attitude what you should have. Challenges are limiting yourself. Is money a limitation? No. Is the place a limitation? No. Technology? Absolutely no. Education, compared to rest of the world, you are blessed with, because you are having education, professional course, that knowledge you exploited. Family is a constraint? No. Age? Not at all. And if you could look at age, right? Who is this guy? Ritesh Agarwal. About him, you know well. And I have to highlight here, SoftBank is a central bank of Japan. They are looking at his business, means think about the opportunity and the scope of doing business, right? And at the age of 21, this is the right time for you people to convert your ideas into business models. And to handhold, your faculties are there, your institution is there, your IIC cell is there. Make use of it, right? And the multi-millionaire, we'll call it as unicorn companies, isn't it? So billion-dollar companies, we'll call it as unicorn company. And all IIMs and IITs are working for him. And to end this session, I wanted to stress on this. Look at the Indian startup ecosystem. And recently, the survey reported that India is the second largest startup ecosystem. This is a major statistics that you need to look at. 85% of startups are in metro and 40% incubator annual growth. That means the incubation centers make use of your institution incubation center and IIC to convert your ideas into business. Look at the growth. 85% of startups are in metros only, right? And average age of founder is 28 years. See, I want you to see one among this. So people say always negative about country, but try to identify and exploit the opportunity in our country. Because I'm really liking this last quote I wanted to share with you. We are not only a country of billion mouths to feed, but also a country of billion minds to innovate. I want you people to one among these billion minds to innovate. So wishing you good luck. I'm highlighting why you need to go for this. Look at the statistics. So you have early exposure, you can address unemployment, and you can failure and you can process it by your skills and create you to attempt challenges. And very, very important thing is the present market. India needs 2 million jobs. Look at whatever red color I have highlighted. Limited job creation in government and large industries. And every year, 5 million plus college students are coming out of the education institution for job market. And 1 million projects or theses every year. So my sincere advice and suggestion, take up a challenge. And that challenge you need to convert as your project or thesis and come up with a solution in terms of your business ideas, right? So with this, I'm going to stop my presentation. You are your own brand. Be your own brand. Believe in yourself and have a fire in a belly. Thank you one and all for your patience listening. Hope I made up my presentation a decent one. Thank you. Yeah, Tejaswini, you have something to do. Tejaswini.
Any children got any doubts, please ask and interact. And if you wanted to connect, you can connect. Okay. So, it's good.
Ma'am, I could see two people raising hands.
I think you can unmute yourself because your mics are enabled. If you wanted to really talk to ma'am and ask, you're always welcome. Another 2 to 3 minutes or 5 minutes we can spend for question and answers. No questions?
Yeah, students, any questions you can ask to the madam is waiting. Kaustav, Shashikala, any queries? Any ideas? Also, you can present with the madam. Madam can give idea.
Definitely, sir. Definitely.
Yes, Shashikala. Shika Pandey.
Uh,
Nirmala ma'am.
Hi, sir.
Rakesh sir here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's what, actually, as we all know that one, our central government has initiated Smart India Hackathon. Since yes, 4-5 years, there are a lot of challenges are offering to the students, especially technical college students. This is the right time where we can, as Poonama ma'am said, where we can motivate our students to take up the various challenges in various domains. And we can also look for some support from Dr. Poonama ma'am.
Definitely,
sir,
definitely.
Set up students, group of students for various domains and various organizations. As we all know that when ISRO, HAL and NAL, they're all offering different challenges, which is societal requirement. And also we can motivate students to come up with the various challenges what they are facing currently. It may be a small, so it is, we should motivate and we should encourage the student. That's what I would like to say. And whatever madam has delivered is really very good. And all our innovative ideas, which are where we are getting the fruit of that one. Previously, we were also facing those challenges in our life, but those guys, they have come up with the solutions and we're able to get the solutions and we are getting those, we are getting all those solutions over there. Thank you so much for the presentation. It was a wonderful presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Poornima ma'am.
Yes,
sir,
ma'am.
Is Professor Prakasha, who is our registrar and officer in EC department, and our my dear own colleague, really.
Thank you, sir.
Department.
Yes.
So that's the one more thing. Like even I wanted to highlight such a beautiful and elaborative presentation. You gave it through the pictures. You made every one of us to understand the values, the requirements, and the motivation. What we got it from the n number of so-called the well-established entrepreneurs. So, and what innovations they thought and they have implemented and gave it to the society and the country. So actually, on January 26th, it was being celebrated, and that has been the day they have celebrated as a National Startup Day. And as you, yes, rightly quoted that, we stand. Ultimately, the Prime Minister Modi ji, he announced on that day saying that the country will celebrate this day as a National Startup Day. So every year, January 16th will be the National Startup Day. And we all know that. And as even in his speech, he presented from Ministry of Education also, the startups are the backbones. Okay. So for our new India, so even Prime Minister and all of our dream will be touching that by 100th year of Independence Day. So the power of the national economy should be in the heights. We should stand in the first. So we are towards that, and even the government of India is towards that, and they are helping a lot of MSMEs to come, the small scale industries to come with a loan, with all the facilities, and even recently the budgeting, what they have done, our so-called Nirmala, the finance minister, who has announced. So there are a lot of opportunities. Just we need to set our mind, our young generation, our own students, to come out with the idea. We are there as an institution, the platform to give them the basic foundation. We are here, then they can take it forward. We are here to give them the platform to convert their idea into a product, and the proof of concept and the patent. And even we will place them to be there with the premises and the office, everything. We try to give it free of cost for them for 11 months. Like that, we have also got our own students who are passed out, to be frank, up to last year, that they have become entrepreneurs. They started their own companies, but parallelly, I would like to say all my students who are there in the live meeting today, that they're working for another client. Means they're working for a company, but they're parallelly running their own companies. See the mentality of those children of 21, 22 age, really hats off, to be frank. And they're all the role models. And from IIC, really, I'll try to bring them back to talk to our children, like how they started being in the fifth semester, fourth semester, how many internships they have done, and how they motivated, what idea they got it to start their companies,
And along with the academics, they are standing good as entrepreneurs and as the employees of another organization. So really thankful to you. And I would like to thank, to be frank, Divya, who is not there. I would like to say this because due to some emergency call, she has to start and travel. And she requested me to continue the hosting of the event. We are the team. We work for the team. And we work for SVCE Bengaluru. Okay. So now I would like to request Professor Pundleek Chauhan sir from CSC department to propose the oath of thanks.
Yes, ma'am.
Over to you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Can you hear me, ma'am, very clearly?
Very, very much, sir. Sir, you can start, sir.
Thank you. Good morning to all. I, Pundleek Chauhan from CSC department, SVC Bengaluru. Yeah, good morning, respected our CED sir, Dr. M. Shashidhar Muniyappa sir, and our beloved principal, Dr. Nageshwar Gupta sir, and IIC convener, Dr. Nirmala Gupta madam, and today's event convener, Dr. S. C. Lingareddy sir, and all other HOD and various department faculties, and our registrar, Professor Prakash sir, Dean Academics, Dr. Poonima madam. With this, it's a great privilege to propose the vote of thanks for the today's one-day workshop. So appreciation can change a day, even change a life. With this small vote, I would like to express hearty gratitude to today's resource person, Dr. Poonima K., Associate Professor, Department of MBA, SJBIT, Business Consultant, and Soft Skill Trainer, Bengaluru. So we thank you, ma'am, for your
thank you, sir.
From IIC, SVC Bengaluru, so your for your interactive sessions, because you have given very what are the real-time applications. Already the established entrepreneur examples and what exactly they have faced the problem and they have come for the solution for the problem. So that is really makes the students to understand what exactly they need to plan for the futures. So thank you so much for live interactions and giving the such a idea to the young minds. Thank you, ma'am. I acknowledge the management, our CED sir, Dr. M. Shashidhar Muniyappa sir, his support and making this event successful. Thank you, sir. And I would like to thank our beloved principal sir, Dr. Nageshwar Gupta sir, for his constant support and guidance for all the aspects. And I would like to thank today's event convener, Dr. S. C. Lingareddy sir for his continuous support and guidance. And I thank the Professor Prakash sir, Registrar and Dean Academics, Dr. Poonima madam, so for their guidance and support. I would like to thank the events coordinators for their constant work and successful for this event. And last but not least, I would like to thank all the students participants who had invested their valuable time and listening patiently. That is very important. And lastly, I thank the backbone of this event, Dr. Nirmala Gupta Madam, IIC convener, and all the coordinators of IIC, giving me this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks. So once again, thank you all. Thank you. So over to you, ma'am. Nirmala madam.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. The entire team SVCE, I would like to thank. And the special thanks to today's speaker, Dr. Poonima, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Seek your coordination and the assistance and even a lot more offline activities on design thinking, critical thinking,
Yes, ma'am.
Because we are into that. We are the first institution to about this design thinking. Last 4 years back, as sir told, like principals are mentioned, and we are into that, and we take care of the whole process to go meticulously phase by phase.
Yes.
So probably we'll have live activities to our students from your end also. I'll seek an offline meeting or a session or an activity probably by end of this semester, once they complete their exams. And sure, once they come out freshly for the even semester, soon within that week or 2 weeks, we will have this activity to be done, sure, as a 2 days workshop, something like that.
Sure.
So meaning the talk will be there, activity will be there, and the fun will be there. So yes, like that, we will plan it out to make them also entertained, because they're also eagerly waiting for the entertainment, both blended mode of learning and entertainment co-curricular. So we can make that as the combination, and we can bring out the design thinking with all the activities wherein the children will have the fun, the entire college. It's not for one department, we'll do it for the entire institution. And even MBA is there, and it's your core department probably. you can even have a plans to give some inputs to the MBA students of integrated MBA, yeah, but we are having it in our college.
Yes.
So 100% no doubt. So from Monday, the exams are starting. So we'll just see that within a month or 1.5 months, it will get over. So we'll see the viability of the students immediately after the exam. 5th and 7th, we'll combine and do the event. Then again, 1st and 3rd, I mean, sorry, the 2nd and 4th and 6th and 8th, like that, we'll make a combination. So yes, we will really have to be associated with you. And I would like to seek that same thing from your end. And even the other people who can contribute along with you, we're always welcome from
you. Yes, ma'am. I'll connect to one person who can talk on patents, especially for your students, right?
Good.
He's from Karnataka State Patent Department, and one person from InnoMantra. Definitely, I'll connect that person with you. I know that you have that frequency to have good network. And happy to note that your principal sir, your registrar, and your entire team, everyone speak the same frequency. That's a very, I feel I'm part of your institution.
No, the likely minded people.
Yes, what yes.
Say is, who can sync? Who can
I never sync? Felt that registrar is new person. I never felt that your principal is new person. I feel that I'm part of your institution. thank you for making me to feel at ease. Thank you very much.
No, yes, always. Culture, ma'am.
Yeah, yes, that is the SSC culture, and even sir is like that only. As I knew it beginning also, before he was there and he went for short span, he came back the same the person, because whom I met 5 years back also, the same Gupta sir, who was a head and vice principal at that moment. And there is a change, but still sir thinking is same.
Yes, I could make out the way he was.
For the institution, the thinking is still the same. With a high frequency, it is increased. I mean, sir, yes, wanted everyone to be the part of the process in the same wavelength.
Yes, okay. Yes.
Thank you. Thank so you nice. Again to all thank of you. And I troubled everyone on a holiday. morning, sorry, because of Purnima ma'am's schedule, because she is also working today in her organization. She too have to teach her children, and 2 to 3 hours of schedule she got, and late afternoon, I feel it won't be good enough for all our children having the lunch and all. So that's why I thought morning 9 to 10 is the kickstart of the day. So sorry, really extremely sorry for bothering all of you for attending this from 8:30, 8:40 only we were online. So really sorry.
Madam, I joined 8:40 only.
Yeah, I know that. I was only a little bit delayed.
I wanted to make sure I should be on time.
Yeah. So after madam, I joined and I called Nirmala madam.
Thanks, sir.
No issues, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.